didn't go anywhere.
I do the wave first. Then it goes to you. Then it goes to you. That's
why
the wave.
Is that always got to be him?
You start the wave.
You do the wave then.
No, I don't.
If you started, he would. I would be the last one.
Oh, well, hi, awkward.
Yes.
Welcome.
Hergelmurfs.
Hergelmurf Nation. What up? How's it going? I'm RJ.
Guillermo in the house.
Ben.
And just in case we went too fast to actually title it this week, hi, I'm RJ.
Guillermo Garcia Santa Marina.
And Ben.
And perfect. Ben. All right. We are Epic Environments. Pretty much your resource for all things audiovisual, Hergelmurf, and installer integrator
news.
Yeah, this
cool stuff. Cool gadgets. Things. Cool things.
News is
electronic wise.
Yep. Name of the game for this episode. Mm-hmm. Before we jump into it, though, we want to just talk about a couple things real fast. Number one, remind everybody out there that you can find us at
www.epicenvironments.com /epictv.
Yep.
Sorry.
All right. Cleanly, Ben, maybe you can reiterate that.
www.epicenvironments.com /epictv.
All right. Close enough. We can also be found on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram. All you got to do is do the little at sign
and subscribe.
Epic ENV.
Comment E-P-I-C below, please. ENV. Talk to us.
Now, all that's out of the way. One more little teaser of something else that's dropping this week.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know how much we want to tell them about it, but we do have another video that's dropping this week.
Mm-hmm.
This one we actually took a trip for. Like, we went out of our way for this one for you guys. We try to get you the answers that you're looking for. Somebody had kind of hinted they wanted to know about this particular thing, so look for that. In fact, we'll probably drop it today or tomorrow, yep. I think. Because, we got to get that information out there. It's vitally important.
Oh, extremely.
Vitally important. Has to do with outdoor audio. Outdoor audio.
Environmental audio.
Yes, and in particular being conscientious of your environmental impact.
Yep.
With outdoor with outdoor audio.
Yep.
Almost got through that without laughing.
Wow. This is a huge solid sound build up. Outside.
Huge build up. It's a fun video.
I forgot to start recording on that.
We had some fun making it. We hope you have fun watching it.
Yeah, it's going to be it'll be entertaining at the least for you guys.
Right.
Today we have, so here's how the show usually works, just for those of you out there that are kind of curious. During the week, as we kind of go about our stuff, we come across different things in the news and different things that are kind of cool that we want to share with you guys. And so we create this list, this really, really long list, and we try to get to as many as we can in an episode.
Mm-hmm.
But this list just kept growing and growing and growing. And because it's news, we need to make sure that we get to a lot of this. So today, we're going to do some cleanup. This is rapid fire news.
Oh, no.
We're going to grab this paper. We're going to pass it around. We're going to start with Guillermo over here.
Okay.
And we're just going to grab the top of the stack. We're going to throw it out there. I'm going to pull up the links, and we'll give it our 2, 4, 6 cents.
Okay, you don't want me to just sift through this and pick a random one?
Yeah, do random.
Okay.
All right. I like random better.
Pick a paper, any paper?
Okay, so it's the 120-inch...
Oh, lucky you.
No.
Just conveniently the last thing he added to the list.
No. It's the Ovizio.
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 Ovizio. Ovizio. All right, what do we got here? Ovizio.
Okay, so when I first saw this article, I thought, hey, Vizio 4K. I was actually interested because it said 4K and it was their high, their
so this is highest a new resolution product they're announcing,
TV
right?
They had, and yeah. I wanted to check it out.
The what reference?
And then when I looked at it, I was like, wait a minute. It comes with an integrated 5.1 audio squared visionary design system. It's basically
squared?
A sound bar underneath the monitor portion
right.
of the whole unit. And it's $59.99, 65-inch, and it goes all the way up to 120-inch, but the 120-inch wow. does not come with the surround sound system. Just
what?
Just the 65 inch.
Right. Right. There's two options available. It's either
this is the
if you want a 4K
here.
But you go up so big.
Super okay. Reference series. The Reference series.
From Vizio.
Anyways. Spec maxed out, you know, it's 4K Ultra HD, a high dynamic range and ultra color spectrum.
Mm-hmm.
On top of that, you have the surround sound system built in. So I thought to myself, now, hey, wait a minute.
What do you mean surround sound system built in?
Integrated 5.1
audio.
Yeah,
it's like
audio.
Integrated to
so
the screen.
So right down here at the bottom.
Let's see.
Instead it's, of just being a
so
sound
instead of
bar.
Having external sound bar, it's an internal sound bar.
Oh, nice.
Oh, Vizio.
Oh, Vizio.
Right. Now, I don't know. Ben, do we agree that it's best to keep components separate because then you get the best fidelity?
I mean, I'm of the thought that the right tool for the right job. So, you know, but, you know, hey, you know, some people like that all-in-one package. And for that market, it's great, I guess. I'm sure it sounds pretty good.
So there's a sub got a hefty and price two rears that you can... Mm-hmm. There's in a kit.
Okay.
And basically, it's your whole surround sound system all there.
It looks like here, it says it also has a available, it says the 10-inch wireless Bluetooth subwoofer delivers deeply resonant window-rattling bass as low as 20 hertz. Ooh. With the convenience of placing it anywhere in the room.
I doubt, well, look at that 20 hertz.
So
it's on the website.
What do you guys think? I thought for... $5,000-$6,000, you got a TV and the whole system.
The whole system, yeah. I mean,
you know, wireless.
Nice. All in one package, it's decent, yeah. I mean, I'd love to see the picture of it, you know.
Mm-hmm.
It doesn't look like it's a 5.1 surround bar.
No.
It's a 3.
It's a 3.1.
It's a 3.
Sorry, I misspoke.
Right. It's a 3, okay. And then the 0.1 is the sub, and then you have the two surrounds.
Right, and then the surrounds are probably Bluetooth or something as well.
Yeah, I believe they are.
Immersive. Yeah, okay. So that's what I thought they were taking like the Yamaha soundbar technology, the virtual 5.1 when you said that, and putting it in the bottom of a Vizio screen and selling it for $6,000. I was like, whoa. Whoa.
Yeah, no.
No, okay. This is actually I can see a market for this now. Like you know,
for the all-in-one.
Where would you put
you know?
This? Where would you put this? In a living room, bedroom?
An apartment. A college dorm room.
It's surprisingly thin.
Perfect.
Yeah, I mean that would be. This isn't like I think the main showcase piece.
Sweet TV though.
Yeah, this is a great package for a secondary system, a third system, something along those lines. If you wanted to throw a TV in the garage, hint, honey.
Full surround sound.
Right, and 4K. Have a quick, you know, Bluetooth surround sound. I could see this being perfect for something like that.
Well, there you go.
Would I make this the masterpiece theater?
It wouldn't be a reference. Now, what about
I'm
the
sure
one,
it looks
120
great.
Inch now? Okay, so Vizio's got the reference series, 120 inch, class ultra, HD full array LED smart TV. It won 2015 Best of Show, and twice. You know, the magazine, twice.
$129,999.99. Okay.
You do have to special order it, but...
I would have to see this thing for like a week
somebody
before
said
I could drop $120,000 on it.
So somebody rated it...
3 months. 90 days.
The Verge. This ranks as perhaps the best looking TV I've ever seen.
Yeah, I wonder.
Oh, my God. Look at that thing.
120.
In a world...
I mean, that's obviously just a complete, you know, touched up photo, but I would be interested
super
to see it in person.
Photo.
I would be interested to see it in person because that's, see, and maybe, you know, here's the interesting thing. If Pioneer released a 4K 120 inch and people were touting it the best of the best, boom, no, hands down. Like, sure, I'd need to see it, but I'm already practically sold because Pioneer has delivered a level of quality in the past that I can come to expect. You know what I mean?
Ooh, are you saying Vizio trust has not quite met your
trust but verify? Like I trust a Pioneer.
Specifications.
Do I trust a 120 inch Vizio? Because sure, they've done some great TVs. There's been some good looking TVs, but there was many, many issues at the beginning of Vizio that you would hear about.
Oh yeah.
You know what I mean? They weren't known for the
and
quality.
And the color was always funky to me. It never seemed real.
Right.
Never seemed
right. Right.
But so, anyway, and I see that. I feel like that is the same for a lot of LEDs. I don't find them to look that real, but there are some out there that I like.
So do we think that this is Vizio like really trying to make a play for the high end market?
In their game. Mm-hmm. They're up in their game.
Yeah.
But I'll tell you what, just for the people out there, and if you don't already know, because you're an installer, a technician, or a
Herbomurf Nation,
this thing is massive. It will definitely take some structure to hold it up. If you're going to mount this bad boy, you know, let's say in a conference room or something like that, you want that to be backed with three-quarter ply for sure.
Yeah, no.
If you're going to drop $129,000
on a conference room,
make sure on a television,
you bolt that thing
room.
Up. Anyway,
especially in California, earthquake. Yeah.
You know,
like
you get
90s
city in conference
here.
Rooms all the time, and those things are.
I'd like to see it, and I'd like to see it next to a comparable television.
Copy
like,
that.
I would like to A/B this before I could actually give it the RJ stamp.
Yeah,
of
give
approval.
It the.
Okay. All right. Good one. Good one. Okay. So moving along, huh?
So you're gonna get on ordering that, right? We'll get one in next week.
Well, okay. So then Ben and I were talking about it, right?
Oh.
And we were saying, hey, for 129 G's. Or,
right.
Wait a minute. $129,999.99. What else could you buy?
A lot of things.
I was saying one of those, you know, camper trailer puller thingies. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
It's got
and just buy a cheaper TV and put it in that.
Dude.
There you go. Done.
Just saying. But, you know. Everybody has their priorities.
You
and
don't
it depends
get the
on
120.
You
don't
watch.
Get the 120. You get the 65 integrated, and you put that in the trailer. Done.
Boom.
Boom.
Best of both worlds. And we'll be camping when we're watching cool videos.
Yeah.
In
surround sound.
We can't forget the truck that has to pull that thing too. So.
Oh yeah.
Anyways, news.
Yeah. So who's
something
next?
Something that I think is kind of cool. Or you wanna pull the next one out of here?
Yeah, let's see what we got.
I'm going to throw this to the magic can. Where's
We didn't do the magic can this,
wait a minute.
This week.
Okay. So just aim for the camera.
which camera?
I was going to aim for that one, but
No.
I'll aim for this
aim whatever one you want.
Jeez, I'm horrible at this.
No, where's the bucket? I want the bucket
this
back.
Guy.
There's a fan in here or something blowing that. Did you see the curve on it? It was... Anyways,
go ahead, Ben. Take it away.
Okay, so I guess I'll just take the right off the top, and this is the rear vision backup camera kit.
Mm.
That was kind of cool. I checked it out. I think it was, you know, it's interesting. It's I think it advertises as saying no wires.
Yeah, because it's solar powered.
It's solar powered?
Yeah.
I did not see that. That's amazing.
Yeah. So the ring that fits over your license plate. Original license plate cover holder. It snaps on top of that.
Yeah, no, I saw that.
Powered by solar panels on that ring, that bezel.
Really?
Then you connect the, there's a wireless module that connects to the, is it the DMB sensor?
It's the
DIN cable or something like that.
Yeah, the BDM or something.
There you go.
MDB and BDM, I don't know.
Yeah, it's one of those. Most vehicles have them now, and it's underneath the dash.
Yeah, it's the data port.
Exactly. So you stick it into there. That communicates with the two cameras on the back license plate holder.
So when you go in reverse, is that where it automatically pops up, or do you have to be in the app for it to...
Well, it comes with a holder, so you have the phone up on your dash, and then I would believe that you would be in the app.
Yeah.
Which is the part of this that kind of, I don't know, it's a win and a lose for me. You know what I mean? Like, what if I'm on the phone? You know what I mean? What if I'm going from place to place or somebody calls or something along those lines? Like, is it going to, you know, interfere with that? Is it going to try to automatically overtake the phone call, or does phone call trump the backup and I don't have my backup camera? You know what I mean? Like, I could see a scenario where, and this is just me maybe, but I can't imagine I'm the only one like this, where, you know, you're out there running around trying to get from A to B, and you're on the phone with this, and you hop in your car. Usually your Bluetooth takes over, and you put the phone into whatever charging dock, and then you just kind of go with your thing. But now I got to like line that up. I got to set it up. I got to make sure that it's horizontal now instead of vertical.
It can be vertical or horizontal.
Ah,
yeah, it can.
It makes
actually. I think in portrait mode, you can scroll left and right a little bit to actually see the
perspective,
the wider range of the image. You know, so it does give you the full portrait mode, but you can scroll left and right.
I have to believe then. Your phone call won't be cut off on those.
Yeah, I think phone is going to take priority there because, I mean, you're not always 100% using your phone as a backup camera, yet you're usually always using your phone as a phone.
Right.
So, but yeah, no, it seemed pretty cool. And it's got two cameras that it seems to blend. So, you know, it did look cool. What was the price tag on this thing?
It is, hang on.
I think it was like $500 or something.
$499. Comes with the
camera. Only $499.
Jeez. Another $100, you could replace your entire head unit with something that has a backup camera.
Well, that's just it, though. This is convenience. The only reason that why I think convenient. It's kind of a cool thing is for someone who doesn't have a camera on their car already.
Okay.
And wants something very clean, very easy to integrate with something they probably already have.
Yep.
iPhone or Android. This is a cool solution. It's convenient. It goes along with that.
Can you set it up on your front bumper?
I would imagine. No, no, it's completely wireless.
Rear vision. It specifically says rear vision.
Oh, that's what it says.
I could see a much wider use for it if you could set it up on your front bumper. Because, like, I have a rear view camera on my back bumper. Mm-hmm. It came with my head unit, which was slightly more expensive than this, but not much. But I don't have my front bumper covered. And, you know, I'm in a bigger truck. So, like, I drive my truck. Well, I know where the bumper is, but you know, that front angle would be kind of cool to have.
I don't see why it wouldn't work on the front.
Here's where I think it wouldn't work unless you can flip the image. Chances are they're going to flip this image for you in your image on your phone so that when you back up, it's like you looking in a mirror. You know how they do that? They flip all those images. So think about that. If it's already automatically flipped because they assume it's on the rear, probably not going to be reflipped if you just put it on the front. You'll have to actually compensate mentally for that, in which case.
All right, so.
That's a good point.
Here's another thought.
Good point, Ben.
Sounds like you got to just
compatible cars of 1996 or newer. That's kind of cool.
Yeah.
Have you ever seen those bird's eye cameras that are on the cars?
Oh, I love those.
I would buy this in 2 seconds with or without my own rear view camera if this did bird's eye. Yeah. If it was a series of the however many four or five cameras, they go right
cameras,
underneath your
front,
rear view.
Back and two side mirrors.
To give you that, I would
3D
hands down. Hands down. I think that
is
the coolest thing.
Well, maybe
we'll
find one of those bird's eye view things.
That's right.
On the next podcast.
Okay.
All right. So anyways, kind of cool.
Yeah.
$500. This goes along with that camera doorbell thing that we talked about last.
Yep.
Okay, so anyways.
All right, what you got? Whatever this next random topic is here on the top of the list, and we are talking about a new I remember you found this one.
A new
TiVo with 3 terabytes of storage.
Oh, yeah.
My first question.
Sorry about that.
TiVo's still a thing?
I guess
yes,
so.
DVRs, buddy.
Well, DVR, but DVR is not TiVo. Like, TiVo's a brand
TiVo,
of DVR.
Yeah.
That is.
But they were the ones that started it all, man. They were the ones that were. I agree.
I know,
but now, but now it's integrated
in every box.
The 90s.
That Wi-Fi
that
Bluetooth antenna you were talking about last week has TiVo built into it. You know what I mean? Or not TiVo, it has DVR, which is TiVo.
Yeah, essentially.
TiVo is
not with a little TiVo C do? In the circle, but you know.
Intuitive into how you watch, and it's there's a thumbs up, thumbs down.
I know, but it's an external box.
So
I mean, the one thing it's got is the fact that it has 6 tuners available or something. But how does that integrate into your existing cable device?
I love the first line on this. It says,
look on the back. It's go ahead.
It says, TiVo's new set-top box can record over 130 hours of 4K content.
Mm-hmm.
It says, when, you know, broadcast 4K actually becomes available.
That's true. Until then. Ooh.
Ads.
Oh, man.
Anyways, for
another
$500. For a regular person, this is kind of cool because you don't have to lease something from a satellite company. you could buy it outright, and you get to keep your content and your own hard drive at home. So I think it's kind of cool because
it's got a lot of space, but I mean, it, you know, I'm just trying to think, like, how do you make that seamless into, like, is, that just goes just after your cable box goes, plugs into that.
Or you could use the internal tuner if you want, but it only will record.
And that works with, like, satellite and cable companies?
It says, like the Bolt, the Bolt Plus will be able to record broadcast content or stream 4K videos from sources like Netflix and YouTube, and comes fully stocked with apps like Hulu, Amazon Video, Vudu, Pandora, Spotify, and Plex. So basically, this is a, for lack of a better way of putting it, it seems like it's an Apple TV with the ability to DVR over-the-air broadcast. Not cable stuff.
Yeah.
Just over-the-air broadcast. Yeah. Otherwise, it would say...
You can connect a satellite box to...
No, I know, but it says this one is upping its predecessor with a super spacious 3-terabyte hard drive, a ludicrous 6 tuners, and a price tag of $4.99. What is the 6 tuners?
So you can record multiple content at the same time.
Multiple input sources?
Multiple channels.
Through?
Broadcast.
Through just broadcast. Mm-hmm. Not like multiple satellite channels, multiple cable channels.
I don't believe there's...
Sorry.
Whoa.
This stupid ad.
Whoa.
Every time you scroll by it, it does this.
You're right. No.
Yep.
Okay, so, but on the upside, for $4.99, because you think about an Apple TV's, I think they're $2.99
or for their new one
or something, and it doesn't.
Oh, no, I'm sorry, $1.99 and $1.49.
Right, and it doesn't have any DVR functionality into it at all. It's just a streaming box plus access to all the app stores and all that good stuff.
There is a memory to it, though. There is,
but not to like DVR broadcast stuff. This, and that's the point I'm making, is like, to me, that seems kind of cool. And I have Apple TVs, but, you know, really the only thing we use on them is Netflix or YouTube or HBO Go or something along those lines, or the Apple TV, you know, rental space. But with this, you get access to 90% of that, and you could get all your over-the-air HD. So again, cutting the cord from the cable company. And still maintaining your DVR. So that'd be kind of cool for $500. It's right in there.
Yeah, that's actually a nice little feature. Plus, you can, I mean, I guess if you can stream it, you usually always have access, but I would assume you get to record anything you can stream to. So,
yeah.
If you wanted to keep that
you
local.
Can, I believe it has inputs that you can connect a satellite box externally and
that's what I'm figuring, yeah.
Into it and control it with IR or RS-232. But
so this, I wonder. Like, so 3 terabytes of HD. I wonder if it does standard def. But, like, let's say you hooked up a camera to one of the 6 tuners through a modulator. So you put it on, like, channel 37 broadcast. And then you set this up to, like, you know, just start a record at a certain period of time on whatever tuner. You kind of get, like, a pseudo
kind of thing in there. That's cool.
Or even just turn your TV to that channel. Because you'd be able to change, you'd be changing it on the TiVo and be like 37, just modulated right into my TiVo. Boom!
Bam! Boom. Bam.
So there's all these accessories you can add to it. All right. Mini and
I'm sold.
Watch TV Are anywhere. You? That's pretty cool.
Okay, I got to change
change the thing with the stuff. Gee, you're up. Let me toss all these papers at one time over to you.
Oh, you guys want to talk about something?
What's that?
I'll talk about something.
Okay. No, you want to talk? Let's talk.
All right. So I like stuff that goes in office spaces to increase the ambience, the quality of the ambience, to make it feel nice and fuzzy and warm and all that good stuff. Anyways, came across this revolutionary sound and ambient light.
Ooh.
From Indiegogo.
Wait, it combines sound and light.
Yes.
Into one, like, beam.
Yes. And you can commune with it. It's pretty awesome. Awesome. What you do is you take the crystals and you put them in the special pattern. I'll show you later. And you use the energy from the crystals, because they exist in the one, in the first dimension, right?
First dimension.
And then you harness that power into the third and fourth dimension. We'll tell you about it later.
Somebody's been watching the YouTube videos. Okay, so
this is cool because it combines 360 degrees of sound and ambient lighting, and you can make them custom so they can silk screen for you patterns that go over these transducers that connect to a membrane that is essentially the structure or the housing.
And it's like a pillar kind of looking thing, right?
Yeah, and then there's a driver underneath. It has pretty good sound. It's $499 right now on
everything's $500 today. Today's the $500 show.
Oh, there you go. You got it up on the nice.
Oh, she's going to put it together for us.
You can't like make it bigger, but you can, yeah, take a look at it.
Kit. Yes, you can.
You can see the frame membrane, and you can see where the transducers connect right there.
Okay, okay.
Which essentially make it a speaker. And then it's, there's a driver underneath for the low frequencies with the port, so you should get some pretty decent bass out of that bad boy.
All right.
And
with its 4.5.
And it stands kind of tall. I believe it's
a 4.5?
I have no idea. It looked about like a 4.5.
Nice, woofer. Anyways, I thought that was kind of neat because it can fit into a decor.
See the Cat 40?
Yeah, I think it's to attach the transducers.
The RJ45 jack?
Hey, whatever jack they want to make it.
Check out the link to this at the bottom of our paperwork.
It's like this, it looks like a metronome, like a big metronome.
Yeah, but see, there's that screen, and that could be customized if you'd like to have a pattern that you...
Make mine look like a
words
metronome.
Or shapes. It could be good for a kid's bedroom, but it's a Bluetooth speaker.
Okay.
So you can, you know, play music from pretty much.
And I think it doesn't it integrate with Sonos. Yeah. I mean, it's Bluetooth, and yeah, you can link multiple AirPlay units together.
Mm-hmm.
So that's kind of cool.
It's crazy.
It is wild. I feel like I'm at a monument.
Like it's Egyptian, an obelisk.
Emitting
gamma rays.
Classic LED remote.
Mm-hmm. We're gonna beam right out of this story and into here.
Anyways,
this one was yours.
Spruce up, yeah.
You get to.
We talked
it.
About the poor speaker that would spruce up an office. This one's a little bit more affordable.
$499. Yeah, it's like. I mean, it's cool. If you like a lot of pillars around.
I don't know why. Ben, you're always with the punchline. I just
there was nothing.
Reflectively
there was nothing.
Laughed.
Nothing. I thought he was going to create a...
I thought he was going somewhere with
it. Obelisk stereo wireless surround sound system. Okay, go for it.
This was Ben's story.
This was not my story. Then you were just picking him, and it's your turn now.
I was just looking
at... Wait, is this my story?
It's your story.
Oh, it is my story. See, I can't even keep track. See, it was the joke. That was the punchline, yes. Okay, so yeah, this hinged motorized mount, it's actually kind of cool. I think it's basically sits in a drop ceiling, or you can even put it in as when you're doing construction, I guess, to almost any kind of ceiling. And it kind of, it holds a TV, and it'll basically make it look like it disappears for the most part, you know?
Gotcha. And so this is like the master bedroom of like...
Something. These guys have some other cool mounts too, ones that pop out from the wall. But this one seems pretty cool, you know? It hides everything. And
how much does it hold?
About 110 pounds, I think.
Hmm.
So that's enough for almost most TVs.
Yeah, what, sure. A 65-inch? Probably be the max.
Huh?
I don't think it goes that big.
Yeah, it depends on how big LED. The opening is.
With a load capacity over 110 pounds in the standard model, though.
Over.
Hmm. Why is it funny?
So someone who doesn't want to see their TV,
that's got to be a crazy mechanism
out
in there.
Of the ceiling.
Uh huh.
And boom, TV.
Ceiling.
So articulate drum. 110 arms though.
See, we've seen those mounts for projectors and mirrors, right?
Yeah. But a projector, I mean, you can get pretty light projectors, like a whole 110 pounds of
TV
hanging
just
on this thing.
Folds out of the ceiling.
Yeah.
It's got to be a monster.
Yeah, you got to reinforce
Autobots,
that.
Autobots, engage.
All right, that was pretty cool.
Yeah. Okay.
Cool.
All right, cool. Hey,
you like that better
cool.
than my speaker?
That's pretty cool.
Ambient
pretty
light cool. deal? Okay, fine.
Hey, this is rapid fire. We got to... Pick it up. We're not going to get through any of this list.
Dude, hurry up.
Anti-ambient screens is the next story. Let's see. Oh, Stuart. This is the Stuart.
I checked that one out. That was pretty cool.
This thing is... They are talking about a screen that can be basically hung in a high environment or high light pollution environment. There we go. That's the words I was looking for.
Gotcha. Or it's more resistant to ambient light. Right. There you go.
With keeping the contrast ratio up high, which is cool.
That's the thing there. It's resistant.
Yes, exactly.
Everybody already thinks they can just put a projection screen anywhere and it will just, you know,
work. Yeah. I see. Yeah,
this should be something that isn't out there, like publicized at all, where any client can see it, because it's like the secret weapon when somebody's like, yeah, I need to put this in the middle of a mall. And
it's kind of cool. There's a really cool graph on this thing.
Projection. You have to have projection.
This is really cool, because it actually the more of the off angle of the ambient light, the more rejection it has. There's a nice little graph they have, I think, on their website or so. By about a 30 degree off angle is at a point about 0.5 resolution or reflection.
It says here it has no sweet spot axis, which is nice. So it says Stewart also claims that test results reveal the Phantom Halar, HALR, delivers over a 30-to-1 contrast for a 2,000 lumen light output projector in a room with 20-foot candles of ambient light and several sources of light hitting screen surfaces at 40-degree angles. In high ambient light conditions with over 50-foot candles of ambient light directly on the screen, Phantom achieves ANSI standard industry contrast rate, or ANSI standard industry contrast ratio standards.
Of course.
The Department of
Say that three times fast.
Department. Yeah.
so basically what this is saying is that with about 20-foot candles, nothing directly hitting the screen, everything at about 40 degrees off, they're achieving 30-to-1 contrast ratio, which is impressive. I'll give it that, especially with only 2,000 lumen projector. And then when they up it to 50-foot candles, it just meets ANSI standards. So I can't recall what those are off the top of my head, what their contrast ratio standards are. Oh, yeah.
So I just happen to have those right here.
Boom! And, with no, the,
just kidding.
Wow. Oh, yeah. Oh.
Terrible.
Sorry, I got you.
404 not found. That's an error, gentlemen. That's an error.
Did you know you can get this thing up to 40 feet high and 90 feet wide? That's pretty great.
Seamless, right?
Seamless.
Oh, I'm sorry. Seamless, right?
Seamless, right?
Mic etiquette.
Good.
All right, next.
That's G.
Pew.
Hand that over.
Me?
Go random. What? Dig deep. We're taking the cream off the crop there. All right. Let's go for something that's about 3 weeks in the fridge. Or...
Hey, we did this one already. You got to pull this one out. This one's already.
Up. Who gets to toss it?
We did that.
Oh, okay.
Wow. Wow. Uh-huh.
Pardon us while we get our do a little housekeeping.
Yeah. Okay. So... Yeah, we have a lot of them.
Do you are you a fan of beer pong?
Yeah, that's cool.
Do you ever do the bounce? Like, were you a bounce?
Oh yeah. Yeah, two cups.
Here we go.
Two cups.
Oh,
pretty good.
DJI's new handheld smartphone stabilizer is a vlogger's dream.
That thing was pretty sweet. It has nothing to do with home automation, but it was cool.
I was
going
to say, I think Ben just put this in here because he wants us to all like have one of these for our videos that we do.
I don't even know what I'd do with it. It's cool. I want one.
It's just cool. I want one.
It's cool, guys.
It's spiffy.
All right. Let's see.
It's a, let's check out the video.
And you gotta push
the button. Oh, the mute. Muted. Always.
I'm hanging out in China with the new DJI something. Osmo Mobile.
Like, so skip to halfway through. About halfway through.
Powerful feature. It has the computer vision and autonomy.
Yeah, this part right here.
Make sure to
that's right. Okay.
It will follow you. So you can just select the area you want to follow or the facial recognition, and it will follow you automatically.
And it will make sure to always keep me in frame.
Okay, so this is me vlogging Shenzhen using new DJI Osmo Mobile. What's really incredible about
Okay, that's
womp.
That's fascinating.
It is. Is it not?
Dude, that is so cool.
It's just one of those I want
to the Hergelmurph Nation, comment down below if you guys
Okay, now I want one. How much is
really,
that?
Really want one of those.
Everything's $500, so I don't know.
It's probably about
300.
It's 339 euros. Oh. So that's probably like $500. Dang, you're right, Ben. That would be awesome for my tip. Okay, just by the way, guys, I'm going to New Orleans as of tomorrow.
Yep.
On special assignment, undercover. We're doing an expose
on
epic environments in New Orleans.
Well, you can't say.
Oh, shoot. I shouldn't have said that.
No, there's no... wait, why can't he say? What am I not...
I'm just kidding. So, seriously, I'll be in New Orleans.
Dude, how many of these did you print
tomorrow?
Out?
Tomorrow.
Just all of them.
And having that on my trip...
so many that we've already done.
Guys, what do you think? Can we store useful... Or can we store buy one of those for my trip?
Which...
No. I mean...
You could use it. We both have iPhones.
Maybe.
Maybe.
All right. So anyway,
it's like,
okay.
What?
So the one I got, luckily, something I
let's just make sure we don't spill too many beans on that.
Oh yeah. Oh wait, you mean the part about
that part.
The thing with the stuff?
The stuff?
Yeah, no. It's cool. No,
was it
thing,
the invisible ones or?
Yeah, the invisible ones. Okay. So we came across this speaker company that does essentially
Sonance. I like Sonance.
Yeah. So they do this invisible kind of speaker thing where you obviously want to do pre-construction here, but you have the opportunity to make this environment almost completely unintrusive, with speaker components.
Hey, didn't Voitone,
and they just kind of live in the wall.
Yeah, didn't Voitone have something like this?
They had like inducer.
They had the transducers.
Transducers, yeah.
But this is a little bit different, I think. This one,
it's a membrane.
Yeah, it's really cool. Well, you
it's
can
not
actually,
the first time I've
no,
seen
the,
it.
The interesting thing is you can put up to, they say, a quarter inch of material
over it,
and it will still work.
Huh.
So, that's kind of crazy on its own.
So yeah, you basically rough it out in existing construction.
Well, that would be mud, but I would assume that would crack after a while.
Yeah, it's really weird, but it's a really cool concept. And
it is a cool concept.
When you want to, I mean, that's extremely seamless in any kind of, listening environment, to where you have this entertainment of and fullness of music, but nowhere do you see a speaker, So.
So there you go. Cracks.
No cracks.
No cracks.
The future is now, boys.
Yep, exactly. So I thought that was kind of cool,
That is
seamless
cool, man.
Speaker.
Nice
seamless
one.
Speaker.
Nice
Thank
one.
You.
Cool. All right. Random paper. Not that paper.
That was a good one. You weren't even looking. You hit it.
You just like throwing paper around.
That's for epic. That's epic equipment paper.
Oh, nice, nice.
I love random.
Why don't we?
Not that paper.
You want to talk about the LEDs?
What LEDs?
Oh, here we go. I'm going to take this one.
Those LEDs.
I'm going to take this one. Somebody threw this in a little while ago, and I think we should talk about this. 32 feet of seamless 4K video with ViewSonic.
What?
Mm. What?
What?
Yeah.
I didn't see this one, guys.
So this is the AV Network, I believe, broke this story. No, I'm just kidding. That's where we found it. So somewhere in here, ViewSonic. It's the ViewSonic Ultra HD commercial display. And they
Imagine
have their little
creating huge video walls that deliver customized messaging as impactful and stunning as their screen size.
So your typical 2x2.
Imagine doing this on a single display. It's all possible with this incredible single-screen video wall solution from ViewSonic.
What?
The CDP9800 commercial display.
So.
With stunning Ultra HD 4K resolution, vibrant images, and a jaw-dropping 98-inch screen size, the ViewSonic CDP9800
commercial
display
is
ideal for
I get it. It's just huge.
On a single screen.
Right, but
Now with just so one display.
So that it's big already. What's special about it?
Watch.
High impact messaging that won't be ignored.
With over 8 feet
of screen space, come on. Transportation.
Wait for it. Wait for it to skip ahead.
32 feet of 4K.
What?
4K video on a chain display.
So high it's like fashion. You don't need a video wall because we made a bigger TV. But if you want, you can put these bigger TVs as a video wall for an even bigger TV.
4K video right. On a colossal 2x2 video wall.
Colossal, they say.
Okay.
So it's their big 4K panels.
But as
that's cool. I dig it.
This durable commercial grade display delivers really interesting.
That'd be cool for like an airport.
Yeah.
That'd be cool for
a bar maybe when you walk in.
You know, they're actually starting to come out with LED. It's like LCD, but LED wallpaper, essentially.
Mm.
And
really?
And transparent LED panels also. Wow. So you can just see right through them. Absolutely. It's pretty crazy.
That would be dope.
Yeah.
That sounds epic.
Isn't it?
Cool. We'll have to all check right. That out later.
Next. Okay.
Let's see here. Dum 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 dum. Something that's pretty interesting. Predictions by 2020.
By 2020?
You want to do predictions?
Do you want to read the future? Killer bounce, bro.
Killer.
Finding studs with a magnet.
There we go.
There we go.
There
something.
We go. Yeah, we can do that. We can talk about that really, really fast. This week in your epic tip of the week.
Whoa. Killer slide.
Guillermo Garcia talks about magnets and studs.
So I have this handy dandy tool that I wish I had so I could show you guys, but I don't. So
you mean one of these?
With planning.
So a powerful magnet can be used as a tool to help you find a stud. How, you ask?
How?
Oh, how?
Okay, cool. Thanks.
wait,
nice
wait.
One. Way to be on cue on that one.
Hey, Mr. Guillermo, Mr. Guillermo.
Ben, cancel bomb.
How?
So, of course, wood does not have any metal in it, except if there was some nails or screws holding it. The drywall down to it.
The drywall screws.
Dope.
So you rub your magnet on the wall. This is a rhyme that's supposed to go there. Okay. Rub your magnet.
No, resist.
On
resist.
The wall.
Yeah.
Okay. So, anyways, you take your tool, the magnet, and you essentially are going to just pan across the drywall back and forth, and you'll feel eventually it'll pull towards, it'll be attracted to the force.
The force of the nail.
The force.
Nailed
right.
Nailed it.
Anyway, so that's a quick, easy way. I'll tell you what.
You know,
all of us have installed, right?
You got to have it on a string, though, or on a little dangly thing.
You like to dingle yours on, or dangle yours.
You got to have it on a dangly thing.
I always have mine just separate, and I stick it to like a tool into my bag.
Yeah, but I mean, when it swings, you can kind of see the sway of the line.
You're swinging it. You're doing the pendulum technique.
I'm
kind of
like a little bit of a pendulum back and forth. And
I do the swipe.
All right, here's the one thing that lights you guys on, do have off. To be okay. aware of. Just in all seriousness, if you go out there and you try this for the first time in somebody's house with nice white walls and you have a dirty magnet.
Oh, right.
You're going to basically be rubbing
and
the
and
equivalent
that's,
of
no,
a
no,
metal.
But that's the trick. You hold it like you try to be steady. Hold it about a quarter inch off the wall or an eighth of an inch. Just try to keep it right there or it's swinging right
and
in front.
And if you have to be really delicate, just put a piece of paper towel between
newspaper,
or
anything.
Yeah, something.
Okay, so anyways, that's a quick tip. And I think
chances are you're doing that to find where to drill.
Well, also because, look, everybody's had this problem where you have an electronic device in your bag, the battery's dead, mm-hmm. or I don't know if this has ever happened to you guys, but a false reading on an electronic.
A false positive?
Yeah,
false
on
positive.
An electronic stud finder happens all the time.
I don't remember the last time I used an electronic stud finder.
Actually, yeah, the magnet thing is my preferred method of stud finding.
So anyways, tip of the week.
The only thing it messes you up on is like any sort of plaster thing where there's metal grating.
That's true.
I used it in my kitchen, and that was all plaster.
But with metal
it had grating? It had the chicken wire in it.
No one? Okay, cool. Okay. So that is one way. I'm going to jump ahead of you real fast because I want to throw this out there. It works well with that. And then I'm going to go hit the buttons on the cameras. Okay. But you can do it with magnets
or
you could do it with the Wallbot.
Oh.
Or no, the Wallabot.
I see what you did there.
The Wallabot. Ah. So the Wallabot basically is a X-ray vision thing. You obviously you see here. You strap it to your smartphone. And then all of a sudden,
a little battery thing or a cable.
But look at what it actually shows you.
Well, that's kind of cool.
Like sonically, it detects like there's something there. Sonically, infrared. I don't know. Say something.
That's kind of cool.
Yeah. So yeah, you could use a magnet, or you could Wallabot.
Is that $500?
It's like a sonogram for the wall.
That probably.
Tell me that's about $500.
That is $199
deal of the day, ladies and gentlemen.
Well, plus you do have to have a phone, so I think altogether that could be just about $500. Oh, okay, yeah. Boom, dropping the mic and gonna go hit some cameras.
Cool.
Oh, speaking of cameras, cool did we talk about Nest giving security cameras brains from Google's facial recognition?
Shut up.
Yeah. Sure. So basically, Google has this computer vision software that helps recognize people. It's involved in a lot of their different products they release. I know I'm very familiar with. They have an interesting facial recognition on Picasa, you know, their photo cataloging program. But it can just recognize you. You type in who it is one time, and then you find hundreds of pictures that you've had that they're in there, and they just pop up. So I guess. Nest is giving its security cameras, you know, a little bit of intelligence, if you will, from Google's, from the team Google over there. So they do have a little bit more intelligent thing, so they can even recognize you when you come in, and potentially, I'm gonna guess that's like, you know, eventually, if this like the evolution of this is, you have a Nest camera as a security camera or something, and if like you come to your house, it recognizes you. Right. It can maybe unlock the doors for you, or, you know, probably not that, because then somebody would just make a mask or something. Mm.
Well, I tell you what, I've been impressed with our Nest cameras, and the a lot of your security cameras have it, and, you know, obviously most people watching this have installed one probably, and they know this, but for those of you that don't, security cameras have this thing where you can go in and you can mask out part of the image, and if it detects movement, then it's when it will start recording, so you can start recording based
off movement.
If it's
out of the mask, yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
That has always been so glitchy, like for a lot of the systems that we've used in the past. I set it up on the and because I have the dog and different things like that. That thing is spot on. Uh-huh. Like the only time I ever get a notification with it is legitimately when anything taller than, you know, the animal comes. Right, gremlins come to the house. So they nailed. They nailed that. They nailed that.
Stripe.
Nice, so I thought that was kind of cool.
Back stripe.
All right, dude. So it's you guys can't tell, but it's super hot in our studio right now.
A little bit.
AC's warm. See, out, and it's
we turn it off so you guys don't have to hear it drone on in the background. but we're almost done. First, though, we got to get into our epic equipment of the week. Now, this week we've got a little something special for you too. This isn't particularly a epic equipment on any particular brand or a particular model or anything along those lines. What we want to talk to you guys about is one of the really recent, I guess, kind of economical ways to integrate LED lighting into any epic environment.
Any. As he reaches back
epic.
And drops.
Environments.
Equipment on the table.
Ah, there we go.
Whoa.
All right.
Yeah.
So this pile of stuff. And Guillermo, you should go ahead and talk about this because this is all from leftover from an install that he just finished.
Yeah. So we wanted to spice up a kitchen.
I'm going
to
use this.
You may have seen the kitchen video where we installed the TV above the sink. So the owners of the house wanted to make it cooler. Because that's a space that they hang out in a lot. So what we did is we I designed this little LED system. Basically, I went on Amazon and shopped around for the spec'd product that I wanted. So specifically, it was a 5-color LED strip at able to handle 24 volts and also waterproof. So it has the, I guess it's a resin or I don't know.
Yeah, it's a resin silicone kind of silicone thing.
Little rubbery cover.
Right, yeah. And there's 4 conductors. Like your standard LED tape, you can cut it in sections where you can
they're seeing video, connectors. Right?
Yeah, okay. And 24 right. volts the way to go with these things. You know?
Right, right. I didn't want them to be kind of dim. I wanted them to be bright. I wanted the LEDs to be close together so you wouldn't have this sort of spacing out that you get sometimes with the cheaper LED strips where, you know, it's like 1 every 6 inches. This is 1 inch, I believe, or 1 inch and a half.
Yeah.
What's cool is that you can... You search online, so I wanted the strip. So I started with the strip, and then I figured out how many 90 bends I was going to go around these corners of the cabinets. And then I got fasteners for... Please do. This is a joiner. So you join 2 LED strip pieces with this. And then we also have the clips to fasten them down to cabinetry. They come with an adhesive, a 3M adhesive on the back. But keep in mind, these do warm up. So after a while, over a period of time, the adhesive will start to get soft.
Yeah, you always got to resecure this with something other than the adhesive that comes with it.
What's your rule of thumb with this? I went every 12 inches.
You can do that. Yeah, if you're going to hold like have a clamp holding it, you can also, depending on the situation you're in, use just a heavier duty double-sided tape and for outdoor applications, do a double-sided tape. Silicone. You can add some silicone to hold that in place. So the double-sided tape, even more so just to hold it into place while you silicone it in. So
cool. I want to point out that there are different size widths, different widths of LED tape. So there's 10 millimeter, 12 millimeter.
Really?
It's important to know which ones to buy because you don't want, these will not work with the larger width. Thus, you would need to go with something like this. And these are flexible where these are hard. So there's different options out there. There's also these really cool corner 90 bends. And essentially, you open up these.
Yeah, because if you actually look at the tape, like, you can't really turn the tape.
Trying to turn it does not.
So you cut it at the appropriate points on the tape. And then what you have to do is you have to take a razor and you cut off the silicone coating. So you get down to the contacts. And then from there, you slide the tape into these points here. We'll probably have a link
down. Toss me a 90. I want to see a 90.
Check a 90 out. Woo! And so.
There'll be video.
Yeah. So cool. Anyways, you'll need a transformer to go with this to power the whole thing. But there are a lot of cool accessories out there to control like the colors.
Well, let's just talk about the transformer thing real quick. One of the key features about this and the reason that we wanted to share it with all of you guys is this is not high voltage. This is low voltage. Yeah. You know what I mean? You don't have to worry. Like, you can do this yourself. Anybody can if you can operate, the back of pulling the strip off of it and the screw gun to secure it back in there. The wiring is literally just lay it in and snap it down and you plug it into a transformer that you plug into the wall. Mm-hmm. The rest of it controls via your cell phone and all that good stuff. You don't need an electrician. The most you're really going to have to do is probably drill some holes to like run the wiring in your cabinet, but that's
point
about
A
it.
To point B.
Right. Super simple stuff. But anyways, so yeah, that's as far as transformer goes. That's really, really key feature.
And both Ben and I agree, and you agree too. 24 volt. If you're gonna do it right, just get the 24 volt version because you're gonna get
when there's voltage loss at the end of the when there's voltage loss at the end of the run, it's gonna be less of a percentage. When you lose 3 volts on 24 volts, it's not that bad. But when you lose 3 volts on 12 volts,
Talking
about a bigger percentage.
So the other thing I like to point out, just little things like this for people who don't know or have never done this before, installers out there who want to add LEDs to their installs, which is, you know, spruce it up a little bit, guys, ladies. It's so
Hurdle
easy.
Murphs.
If you notice, the wires are color-coded.
Mm-hmm.
So if you look at the LED tape, you'll see a B, a G, an R, you know, a BL for blue, I believe it is. And then a white, a W.
Yep.
So
make sure you're that makes it the easy. Right,
yeah,
right colors.
Because it, you could twist it to work. Sometimes when you cut the LED tape, the contacts won't always be in the same order.
Yeah, yeah.
You have to flip them.
Yeah, depending on which direction you're going and
right.
and how it's being mounted. So
right.
Well, and as far as quality of these things go, too, I mean, this is...
I have not had no problems with it. No customers. Well,
yeah,
have
there's so
it.
Many
and
different
ben,
qualities
you've
out
put it in commercial places.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. I mean, there's plenty of places we put in a lot of LED tape, but, you know, it's... sometimes it's trial and error when you're first trying to find the right products. You know, there's a lot of not so great products out there. Mm-hmm. So it's, you know, it's one of those things you learn over time, what works, what doesn't. And, you know,
what would be, something that you would recommend people make sure that they, aside from the 24 volt thing, look for, when they're selecting an LED
good power
tape?
Supplies, good power supplies. You want to make sure that you're not putting too many LEDs on any one power supply. You want to make sure you know how many.
I got these in, just so you know, I got these in 15 foot. Oh.
Oh, no.
I got these in 15 foot lengths in rolls. They come in these bags. So essentially what I did is I measured out the customer's space.
Yep.
Mm-hmm.
And then I bought one extra just in case. And,
well,
and
here's
cut
the thing.
It down.
They say on the outside of each of these bags, this one specifically draws about 72 watts. So
right.
You figure out how many watts your power supply is, and that's how many you can safely put. And you obviously want to.
I was way under, dude.
You want to definitely always be under. You don't want to max a power supply out. So
what I did was I bought two 80%, transformers.
I would say 80% at the most.
So check this out. I bought two transformers, one for the upper cabinets, one for the lower cabinets. And the reason why I did that is because she was going to use the upper cabinets on a regular basis and then at night turn on the bottom cabinets.
Ooh.
To like an ambient color like purple or blue or whatever. And oh man, it looks really, really cool. She could do all the, I mean, we talked about it before. There was the Wi-Fi bulbs in the ceiling.
Mm-hmm.
So I have Wi-Fi bulbs in the ceiling. I have the tape under the cabinets and at the bottom where the kick plates are. What I did is I gave her a LED controller to control the upper cabinets, and it gives you color control, gives you brightness, it gives you only white or only color, or it'll give you the fade
yeah.
throughout, and it integrates to the app.
Disco mode.
If, dun, 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 you buy the LED Wi-Fi controller.
Again, links to all of this stuff will be in the description down below, as well as on our website.
Epic.
So don't worry, you don't have to write this all down or whatever.
Right.
Like,
so we took the
all
app,
these different components,
downloaded
and stuff,
it to her
especially
phone,
this wire.
And connected the system to the Wi-Fi. When she is on her Wi-Fi at home, she can turn these lights on and off. She can change the color. And this was very inexpensive for her. I believe each roll is, I want to say, $38 to $48, something like that. I think at the highest it was $56. These other small components, I think it was $28. These were
$27.50.
$3.50. These were like $10. So it was a very inexpensive. I had to buy some wire to run through the span through the stove and span around the fridge and that kind of thing. But all in all, I think it was, I think, $300 installed or $400 installed. I can't remember, but
you're talking your cost, not what you charge the customer, because you bought it on Amazon, right?
I don't know what to say right now.
The links in the description below are going to actually be
Did
to more information.
It was
right.
cost.
Let me see its gear and some bright lights. Did you walk by?
Look, you guys charge whatever you feel is right. Okay, We will tell you the cost, and you know you can go from there.
But right.
When you do a good job, let me tell you, it took time to put this under the cabinet and to make it perfectly straight and have those 90 bends suspended with the tabs. I'm telling you, underneath with a 90 drill bit, you know, the 90 angle adapter with my drill gun on the floor on tile for, I was there for a good, and I only did it because it was a good friend of mine.
Good friend.
Yeah.
There's definitely a labor element to this, whether you're pro or whether you're an enthusiast. I mean, it is a time-consuming process to actually lay these out correctly, to put the correct amount of thought into it, and kind of see what you want it to be. As far as executing it, it's simple. It's plug and play, practically.
Sure.
But it is a time-consuming process. Sorry to put you on the spot.
But the truth is that hey, guys, you have your you got a weekend and you want to spruce up a space, light is a good way to do that. And we talk about that all the time at Epic Environments. And I think this is an inexpensive way to do something and to spruce up a job. It's not going to tack on huge amounts to the end of the bill. And a customer can see a definite benefit. Hey, you're illuminating the space.
Yep.
On top of that, you have up lighting, down lighting, all kinds of cool stuff. So anyways, I thought this was a neat little project.
Hashtag smart home.
Special.
It was special. real special.
All right. I think we are... Just about out of time.
Just about?
Just about. We've got like another minute or six.
So people, please comment on what you've seen here today and let us know what you think. And check out our new movie out there. It's seriously funny.
It's short,
funny and serious at the same time.
Funny, serious, seriously funny.
Yep.
It's just a fun video that we wanted to have fun with and show you guys on our little vacation.
Conservation, natural.
Extremely informative.
Extremely.
Mm-hmm.
You heirloom really can't go the rest of your life without seeing this video.
Heirloom strain rock speakers.
Yeah.
You know, none of that off the shelf at the store bought stuff.
Yeah. No,
these aren't genetically modified rock speakers at all.
So. Yeah.
Anyways, check it out.
Organic stuff.
All right, guys, that is it for us this week. Another Epic Environments video podcast in the can.
Yep.
Thanks for joining us. Again, you can find all kinds of show notes and descriptions and links and part numbers and all that stuff down in the description below. Also on our website at www.epicenvironments.com/EpicTV. For Epic Environments, I am RJ.
Guillermo.
And Ben.
And we'll see you next week.
Hasta la vista, baby.
Oh, it's so hot.
Oh my God.
Travis, hey!
Air conditioner.
Oh my God. Ha 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 ha.